Here we are for another round with Bant humans. I'm on the draw this game. This hand is pretty slow, so I'm gonna go ahead and mulligan. This one's much better. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that, especially on the draw. This way I have guaranteed to have a fourth land for company. Well, of course, unless he doesn't play a fourth land, but or, sorry, unless he doesn't play a third land rather. And then let's see, so this turn I'm going to play, or next turn I'm going to play Thalia's Lieutenant, and the turn after that I'm just going to play Knight and get a Plains. So then my Prairie Stream can come and play untapped. That's unfortunate. Well, I don't think I'm going to be able to play my Dustwatch Recruiter next turn, unless I draw a forest. I guess I should have played Prairie Stream first. It's little things like that that, you know, you really need to be familiar with the deck to get down. But yeah, so if I would have played Prairie Stream first, then I could play Night of the White Orchid, get a Plains, then play Canopy Vista and play Dustwatch Recruiter. Okay, so Fortified Village. Okay, so now I can make that play. So I drew that, but I definitely want to play this, but I think I might, instead of playing Duskwatch, I think I'm going to play this Dromoka's Command, because this way I can kill both his Duskwatch Recruiter and his Cryptolith Rites. And then I'm going to go ahead and put a plus +1 counter on Thalia's Lieutenant. Well, I gotta think about this for a second. So if I put one on Thalia's Lieutenant, obviously I can attack for one more point of damage. And if he's gonna play Reflector Mage, I'd rather him bounce my Thalia's Lieutenant. But if he plays something like Displacer, well, I guess if he plays Displacer, he can just blink my stuff anyways. But if he plays like Sylvan Advocate, I'd rather have this be a 3-3, because this can grow to a 3-3 anyways. Or like if he ever gets a Dustwatch Recruiter to flip, or plays like a Lamel Pacifist, I think it's better to put the counter on my Knight. Yeah. Just because, like I said, I can make the Thalia's Lieutenant a 3-3, you know, just by playing another creature, so I'd rather have both my guys be 3-3s. Or, no, God, sorry, I can't put a +1/+1 counter on this, and I can't put a +1/+1 counter fight and make him sacrifice an enchantment, so I would have to sacrifice my Knight. So I'm actually going to play my Dustwatch Recruiter, and then next turn I can use that. That's pretty bad against, I guess it's not that bad against Reflector Mage. It's pretty bad against like Company into Reflector Mage. I am pretty far ahead. I could just trade off this Knight of the White Orchid. And then next turn I just have company. So he has four cards left in hand. I think I'm just gonna, because also the problem is if I don't Dromoka's Command this turn, then if I Dromoka's Command next turn, then I also can't company next turn. But I guess I could activate Duskwatch and cast Dromoka's Command. That's reasonable. I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's just so much better use of my resources. Giving him one turn with Cryptolith Rites, I don't think is too bad. Obviously, I missed a point of damage there by not realizing how exactly my cards worked, but better to learn now than in the middle of a Grand Prix. So it's like he's just Reflector Maging me, which is, you know, perfectly fine with that. So he's bouncing my Thalia's Lieutenant. It's interesting. I guess that makes sense, because now I'm in the same spot. I can't Dromoka's Command to do all the things that I want to do. So I don't think, again, giving him another turn with that is too dangerous. So I'm just going to fire off a company here. This way, if I hit Reflector Mage or Thalia's Lieutenant, now I can do something. Or also Tireless Tracker to play my land. So I think I just want to get Tracker Reflector Mage. Then I'm going to bounce his Duskwatch Recruiter. If I bounce Reflector Mage, I can attack for 4. Yeah, I'm actually going to do that, because also, if once I kill his Cryptolithrites, he doesn't actually have any white mana to recast that. And I'd rather kill his Dustwatch Recruiter than his Reflector Mage with my Jarvoka's Command. I also need to remember to play land. So he does have a company. He must have just drawn it this turn. I imagine he would have cast it last turn. Okay. That's not too bad for me. So yeah, now this turn I get to play both Thousand Ascendant and Jarvoka's Command and draw a card. Let's start with that. Then I guess I'll attack with everything now. If I use Jarvoka's Command first and like fight with that on that, I guess it wouldn't matter because it has first strike, so we couldn't double block anyways, but I might as well see what he's dealing damage to with this. Also, just I want him to block thinking he might still have Cryptolithrites around next turn. 2. I guess I didn't even realize he was low. I've been focusing on the board, but I couldn't have killed him anyways, because if I would have fought an Elvish Visionary and put a +1/+1 counter on one of these creatures, he would have went to 1. So. Do I want to draw a card first? I should have drawn a card before that, because I could have drawn a Thalia's Lieutenant, but as it is now, there's nothing that I would really want to cast if I draw it. So I guess just any creature, but I'd rather cast Jarvoka's Command anyways. So yeah, no, there's nothing I could draw that I'd want to cast right now. So target player, sacrifice an enchantment, and fight. So, 4 color rights. See, I think I want Tragic Arrogance. And that's likely it. I could see bringing... No, I don't really like Gross Boon against Displacer, though. So I don't think I want that. And I could bring a Negate, but... It's kind of narrow. It's basically just for company. It's pretty hard to hit a rights with that. You know, they can usually sneak it in. Before, like, I don't want to be just passing on turn 2. You know, that's not a winning play. And it's not like I have that much I want to take out, either. Probably just going to take out these, like, 2 Thraben Inspectors. Sand is pretty solid. Start with getting just a Plains... Or, sorry, an Island here, and then Plains Lieutenant. And then play Fortified Village, Reflector Mage, and then Canopy Vessel will come into play tap, so I'll have 2 basics. So my mana is perfect this game. That does... Actually, it doesn't really change much. I can just play Fortified Village first and then Plains next turn. Because now I want to play Duskwatch Recruiter. This just pressures him to play something on his turn. You know, I mean, he was likely going to do that anyways, but now if he doesn't have something to cast, he gets really punished for it. And also, since I'm going to play Reflector Mage next turn, I get an extra counter off of this. I guess the counters always break even, because if I cast this after, I would get a counter on that. But, you know, I kind of like having 3-3. 3-3s are good spots to be at in this matchup, just because they have a bunch of 3-3s and 2-3s, so. Just going to Reflector Mage that guy. I imagine Displacers, they're... best card in the matchup. So if I can keep that under control, I'll have a better time. So now he's going to Displace for me next turn, but then I can just company and hopefully find another Reflector Mage for it. Or just overwhelm it with enough creatures. Let's see, 4 mana with no green. Okay, 4 mana with green. That's probably company here. Yep. Loam Dryad Visionary. His companies have not been great. And now I get to flip my Duskwatch Recruiter as well. Let's see, and I'm going to go ahead and attack with this guy. You'd have to trade both of his Elvish Visionaries for it. That's fine by me. I guess I should have played my plane since he knows I have it, but oh well. This way, if he Reflector Mages this, I can recast it next turn still. At this point, if I draw a Reflector Mage naturally, I'm probably going to sandbag it, because I don't want to just lose to a Westvale Abbey. Oh, shoot. Crap. Well, I accidentally hit F2 while that was up, so now I don't get anything. That would have been a double Reflector Mage. That would have been pretty nice. Well, luckily I drew another company, so... That is really unfortunate. So now I don't think I can attack, because if he just companies... Yeah, ugh. I would be in much better shape had I chosen two creatures there. Five mana, Archangel Abyssin. Okay. Well, I'm definitely glad I did not attack. So I think I want a company while he's tapped out. Let's see, because if I hit Reflector Mage, he still won't be able to recast it next turn, but he can cast it on my turn. I guess that doesn't really matter, because even if I end of turn do it, geez, now I only hit one creature. Okay, well, it's better than nothing. I guess if he has a way to flip his Abyssin... That was kind of bad, but that's not the case anyways, because I would want to. I'd still company end of turn to try to hit a Reflector Mage or something. So I can company end of turn for a Reflector Mage, and then I can also upkeep company for a Reflector Mage. And like if, I mean, but the Bant deck, unlike the green-white deck, it doesn't have, like, you know, I don't think it has Evolutionary Leap, and it definitely doesn't have Hangerback Walker. Taking four here. Displacer, okay. I knew he had that. I really need to draw like a Dromoka's Command and have him tap out at some point. So it's not looking great. Well, I guess I have Tragic Arrogance in my deck too. That would be great. Could leave him with like an Elvish Visionary. I don't think I want to attack. It's like he's not using his Displacer just to play around Dromoka's Command, so I'm going to have to draw a Tragic Arrogance. I'm guessing he's probably going to bounce my tracker, maybe? Yeah. Okay. Don't have much time to draw this Tragic Arrogance, but I definitely want to company first there, because if I hit a tracker, I'd want to get a plus I'm swanking off the clue. Well, another not great company. I think I'm going to bounce Abyssin just because he can't recast it right now, and then it buys me another turn. going to displace his Avacyn. Okay, well now I can draw... I guess if I draw Jormoka's command, it flips his Avacyn, which is not good. Because he can, in response to the flip, sacrifice all of his stuff to Westfall Abbey and then just attack me for a million damage. Oh, I can't even cast this, duh. Okay, so it also only costs 2 mana. I play this one. And I just pass, and if he goes all in on his Westfall Abbey, I lose, but hopefully he doesn't. I put one try. I just put a Tragic Arrogance on the bottom of my deck, so I have one left, and I've put, what, five and six cards on the bottom? I put 16 cards on the bottom of my library. There might have even been a Tragic Arrogance on one of the first two that I didn't notice. Still go all in on his Westfall if he wants. Looks like he's not going to, though. I guess I technically still have one more turn if he doesn't go in next turn either. Play Tracker. And I'm just going to... Oh yeah, sorry, it only costs one less mana, too. That's actually great, because now I can... play Evolving Wilds and draw two cards in a turn. So I get three cards to find a thing. But I mean, I'm guessing he kills me this turn. Because what, he can blink two things in a turn. So there goes like two of my blockers. And then untap, like blink more. So he doesn't even have to go all in on his Westfall Abbey. Which has a company here. I think blinking my guys is better than casting company. But let's see what he hits. If he hits like Reflector Mage, I guess it's pretty good for him. Advocate. Okay. Well, I can block those. I mean, I just have to draw. Do this now. So he can't... Well, I guess he could have, because he has Bloom Dried, but... he could, like, blink his Reflector Mage in response and Reflector Mage that, so I don't get a clue. I'm going to draw a card now. So if I draw... Jormoka's command. Well, I guess that doesn't actually really do anything anyways, because then I would flip Avacyn and I would just die. Perhaps it was better to leave up the mana to bluff company. Let's see, so he... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So he can blink three things. So he can leave me with one blocker here. But looks like he's just attacking me for 12, which I can still beat if I draw Tragic Arrogance. Let's see, I'm going to want to keep my Howler around, I think. So I'll just block like this. He could also just have a Negate, but even if I draw Tragic Arrogance and he has Negate, at least I get the information that he has Negate in his deck for next game. Well, I guess I should have not flipped his Avacyn. I should have just chump blocked with both. That was bad. Well, I do kill most of his guys now. If I draw... Well, I have a Reflector Mage. So he's blinking his Avacyn to make him all indestructible. Okay. Yeah, I guess that... is good. Okay, and I'm dead. It still would have been a hard game to win had I not misclicked through that company, but it certainly would have been better. Let's see. I still don't think I want negates. It's so narrow. It might be better than Ojutai's Command, but I do like Ojutai's Command against Avacyn, and just late game against like a top deck displacer. After game three, yeah, I'm gonna keep this one. It's not great. I mean, it's very good if I just draw like two lands, but I am on the play, so I mean, if I don't draw two lands, it's still okay because I have Dustwatch Recruiter on turn two, And then if I brick on a land, I can pass and flip it. And then Dromoka's Command, still use my mana for that turn, and then untap, play Tireless Tracker, so... or a Reflector Mage, because this is going to get a plane, so... Actually, it's a pretty good hand. Jeez, if he's not doing anything here, now I can just play Tracker and a land. That was fantastic. I could also play Land, Tracker, Lieutenant. I think I don't care about the cards this game. I'd rather have the aggression. So I'm going to play Land, Tracker, Thalia's Lieutenant. I guess that flips this back, though. Okay, maybe Tracker's better. Just Tracker, Land. It's not like my lieutenant's pumping this Krellen Horde Howler anyways. Okay, yeah, I like that then. Let's see what he's got. Reflector Mage would be pretty good here, I guess. It'd be okay. Probably gonna bounce this guy. So my stuff is still cheap. I think I just want to play Thalia's Lieutenant. And then we'll draw a card first, I guess. If I draw an island or a Yavimai Coast, I can play Reflector Mage. I could also just leave up Yavimai Coast, because if I draw any of my green 2-drops, I'd rather cast those. Like either a Lamahole Pacifist or another Duskwatch Recruiter. And I don't really care that much about casting Lieutenant if I brick, so I think that's the plan. And then if I draw, I'm going to leave this up, because if I draw Plains, then I can cast Reflector Mage. Okay. I don't love bouncing his Reflector Mage, but it just... I think the tempo's worth it. Because now next turn I can cast Thalia's Lieutenant, and... I always forget this isn't a human on the backside, but... We'll see. I'm probably just going to cast Double Tracker next turn, actually. Displacer here? Okay. Well, I definitely want to... Dromoka's Command that Displacer. So I can go... Tracker... And then I have to Dromoka's Command now. Unfortunately, it's going to flip my Howler, but that's okay. And then I want to have this get bigger, because when he recasts his Reflector Mage, I'd much rather him bounce my Reflector Mage, so this way the plus and plus one counter's there. This puts him to 6. So yeah, he's not in good shape. Also, this flips this back to a human, so now it's going to get pumped by my Thalia's Lieutenant. That's kind of neat. So if he just goes Reflector Mage, bounce my Tireless Tracker, then I can go Lieutenant, Lieutenant. He has to just chump block with his guy. I mean, he might have another creature, though. Okay, so... Now I think I want to go Recruiter Lieutenant. And then this will be a 3-3. So I guess he could double block my Recruiter this way. Where if I go double Lieutenant, he can't. I think I'm going to go double Lieutenant. I don't want him to be able to trade at all. I'm just conceding. Alright, so there was another round with Bant Humans, and I'll be back again for another one.